Let's go backwards in time.
When you started getting late, it'll be the music you love till your casket's in the grave. And the first time I ever got a girl in the sheets, she let Beastie Boys Balls Boutique play on repeat.
Hey ladies,
was a theme song of my teens, and now heavy in the metal for beats. I was a fiend, and for me the outer peak was circa 94. It's just like Dirt McGirt.
Ooh baby, I like it raw.
And the 90s was so bad that those cats made me start writing my own raps and grinding my boat Zack up there on the stage, screaming the motherfuckers like Zack when front and rage. But nowadays, due to such a metamorphosis, it seems hip hop sucks a dead horse's dick. Cause most tracks coming through were so whack that all I wanna do is go back.
Cause I'm an old motherfucker, set in my ways, and now that everything's changed, I'm lamenting the days of hip hop culture when it entered a phase called Buck and Jam Master J, yo, got themselves shot and all passed away. Rap rule the new school, ain't surpassed the days of
the golden age.
What?
These days every man and his dog's a fucking rapper. And that's the reason why they're standing in rap jobs. Cause all you really need to make a track is a laptop. The people release shit who can't even make beats yet. The rap to what sounds like a Reason 3 preset. I know I found the shit that sounded big counterfeit, and the beats and the funk sucked out of it. Cunts are proud of it, because the crowd a big style of a substance. You can kill them all with syllables without making much sense. Your point can be flawed or lacking in heart, yet the label ensures that you're smashing the charts apart. And that's the curse of commercialization. So fuck every jerk whoever worked at a station, giving radio play to the labels who pay for making hip-hop a blatant cliche.
Cause I'm an old motherfucker, set in my ways, and now that everything's changed, I'm lamenting the days of hip-hop culture when it entered a phase called
the golden age.
What?
The golden age.
Before Biggie and Pac and Jam Master J, yo, got themselves shot and all passed away. Rap rule the new school ain't surpassed the days of
the golden age.
What?
The golden age.
If it ain't dead, it's definitely in a coma. It's kinda like a joke, it's so morbid and sick, and it sorta got me thinking that I oughta just quit. But shit, I wanna see the scene back in its prime, so I'ma raise the dead like Frankenstein. While I'm reanimating all the boom bap flows and breathing life into the golden age 2.0. Taking over the scene to change the flow to cream, slapping hipster hoppers out of stovepipe jeans. It flows and rhyme schemes to show what I'm deemed, bonafide king of these open mic fiends. So it's all good to be commercial and pop, but don't be selling your soul and think you're wearing your props. You're not. You think your posse rips sermons when you rock, or let me tell you, all you're doing is jerking each other off.
Cause I'm an old motherfucker, veteran stage, and I'll be steady getting better with age till I'm dead in the grave and giving life to these old veneers and to my
golden years.
And even after 90 when I'm old and weird, growing little bits from my moles and ears, I'm gonna do it how I've done it for my whole career into my
golden years.
Cause I'm an old motherfucker, set in my ways, and now that everything's changed, I'm lamenting the days of hip-hop culture when it entered a phase called
the golden age.
Before Biggie and Pac and Jam Master J, yo, got themselves shot and all passed away. Rap ruled the new